Good morning, everyone. How is the workshop coming? Any comments?
Yes.
Yeah, you can post it on the chat or you can even unmute and talk.
Okay. I can see the chat, some comments are there. Thank you. If there are any questions, please let me know. What I'm going to do is to explain to you different workshops that we have conducted. In fact, I'm going to take one workshop, one massive workshop, and then I'm going to explain to you. And in fact, we even wrote a paper about this experience in a Commonwealth conference. I will show that also. That paper is actually available for anybody. So let me first share my screen. I have, in fact, I told Saurav that I will do it extempore, but I have decided to create a set of slides. So we conducted a workshop to 3,500 teachers simultaneously in 2019. In fact, I'll tell you the date also later, which date. So you can see the logo of FOSSI here, logo of Spoken Tutorial here, so logo of ESIM, IIT Bombay logo. This is Pandit Madan Mohan Malviya, National Mission on Teachers and Teaching. Okay, through that, in fact, we offered this training to 3,500 teachers. How was the training imparted? Using spoken tutorials and video conference based interaction, forums based interaction. Forums, you know, spoken tutorial, you know, video conference based interaction that I'll come to. Right now, of course, we are doing it. It's a routine thing, but in 2019, it was not something that people are doing, but we were well ahead of time. So we did a coordinator workshop on 27 July 2019 and the main workshop on 21st September 2019. So you can, this was done about 1.5 years ago. Coordinator workshop movie, I have a small video here. Let me just play this. Okay, so let me close this. So they're all college teachers, by the way, and they were all given this kit. So I'll talk more about it shortly. And so the main workshop, by the way, this was the coordinator workshop. Remember, I said coordinator workshop and then main workshop. What happens in the coordinator workshop is one person from each center comes. So what are these centers? These are all here. There, we had 119 remote centers joining us. 118 here, if you can count this, it'll be 118. And there is one in Myanmar. Myanmar is the one that is undergone coup recently, you know, just a few days ago. And so we went there. We have a good friend. We have an institute started by the Indian government there. So we worked with them. So that center also joined, 118 from India and one from Myanmar. In fact, we even have a video that records that interaction with us. I'll show that a little later. Okay. So what happens is one person from each of the centers came. In fact, we sometimes recommended even two people because sometimes you know, something goes wrong and that person is not there. So sometimes two people come from a remote center. They come and then we conducted a workshop for them. And this video was taken there. This video was taken there. You can see that there are people. In fact, this big computer lab was full. It was 100 and, you know, look at the large number. You can see Saurabh there. Okay, is this workshop method effective? Listen to my TEDx talk on the effectiveness of spoken tutorials. We also gave a paper. We presented a paper. simultaneous training of 10,000 teachers, two weapons of mass instruction. If you search for this, you will actually see this in the website of Commonwealth. Okay. And then at the workshop, side-by-side learning through spoken materials, because it minimizes the cognitive overload. You all know about it. What is available at the workshop? A-stable multivibrator circuit. In fact, that's the one you saw just now. In fact, I have a picture of this here. It's a GIF file I have created. Let me just show it here. In fact, there it is. See this? This is what they were looking at. It's an A-stable multivibrator. Okay, they have zoomed it. See these resistors? They can actually change these resistor values. By changing the resistor values, they can change the frequency of oscillation, number one. Number two, if these resistors are chosen to be of different values, then the period of oscillation of the two different circuits will be different. So they will light up different extents, for example. Okay. So how does this fit into this? By the way, you see this A-stable multivibrator. You can see that eSIM FOSI here. I don't know if you can see this, right? eSIM FOSI, IIT Bombay. This is something that we created, and it was powered by a battery, 9-volt battery. So in fact, we sent the whole thing to Myanmar also to do this workshop. Okay. So offline version of these tutorials were given. eSIM installation on Linux, eSIM installation on Windows, schematic creation and simulation, simulating an A-stable multivibrator. And look at this, 5, 6, 7, 8. Mapping components. So here they would have simulated. First install it, then simulate it. Simulate this A-stable multivibrator. Then mapping components and footprints, setting parameters for PCB design, laying tracks on PCB design, on PCB, PCB layout for A-stable multivibrator. So they actually learned how to do that. I'm going to explain it in a little more detail. And then, okay, these are the three tasks. The objective of this workshop is to understand three tasks. One is understand the importance of simulation. Once you understand, create Gerber file and then send the Gerber file to a vendor. We gave the vendor information. I'll show you that. Make the PCB. Some colleges said that they had PCB making machines in their own colleges. So they would have made in their own colleges. So we expected all the people to go through the first step, 50% of the people to go through the second step, because creating Gerber file, it was an involved task. And then half of this would have done this. In other words, 25% of the people would have sent the Gerber file and they would have got the PCB made and the circuit also. PCB and the circuit made and they would have got it. Because we gave the details of the component vendor also. Okay, so these are the three tasks. Sending the Gerber file to a vendor and getting the circuit made, details are in the guidelines. If you can see here. Okay, this was the thing that we gave on 21st September 2019. As I told you earlier, it says why simulation is important, A-stable multivibrator and so on. You can see this. How the hardware circuit is arrived at and what are the different resistance values for which they had to measure the frequency. Okay, and then the following companies make PCBs. Okay, and the components with BOM given in the following table can be procured from this. Okay, so, got it. So role of simulation for a set of resistor values, measure the frequency of blinking. This is in the hardware. Do the same on eSIM software through two spoken tutorials, third and fourth. So this is through the hardware, this is through simulation, and this is through hand calculations. And repeat this for different set of resistor values. We had asked them to do it with three sets of resistor values. Okay, create Gerber file through four spoken tutorials, 5 to 8 that I showed. And then create the circuit by yourself send the Gerber files to a vendor, get the circuit made and verify it's working. Details of the vendors are here. I showed you just now. And they had to do it with their own money. And we said it would cost about 500 rupees. But just the thrill of doing it. And we also said that if you do it, then students don't have to go and buy the project. They can actually make all of it. Come up with a use eSIM, design a circuit, get it made, and then you validate it and then use it. Takeaways from the workshop, they can conduct this workshop by themselves for their colleagues and students at their college or school. There were some people from college schools also. This is what I wanted to show you, eSIM workshop in Myanmar. Let me show you that. In a few words.
Thank you, Professor Swanan. We at MIIT are extremely privileged that to be part of it. And today we have 25 participants from six universities here nearby Madrid region. The next time around when we participate, we'll move this venue, the video conferencing room, to a larger place where I'm hoping to have about 100 people. Thank you for letting us in.
Thank
we are very grateful
to you. Thank you, Dr. Raja. Sitting next to him is Dr. Sinha, and he has been an energetic person. He made sure that things are available. Dr. Sinha, would you want to say hello to the participants from there?
Yes, good morning, everyone. Good morning.
Yeah. In fact, Dr. Sinha is actually helping us to dub spoken tutorials into Burmese language and also in Vietnamese. And he is an ACM distinguished speaker. We are really delighted to have Dr. Sinha with us.
Okay. So that was that. So
now what we will do is.
Okay. I'm just trying to minimize that. Okay. Then in fact, we conducted a workshop, also our workshop in Myanmar. Because the big hall that he talked about was available at the time.
So we have Myanmar, Mandalay, Myanmar. Do you have anybody who can say something? Professor Venkatesh is there.
Yeah.
Go ahead, please.
Hello, this is MIIT.
Yeah, please.
This is MIIT. There is no particular questions. Thank you.
Really happy to, really delighted to see you all. You have come on a working day, on a holiday, and you're also 1 hour ahead of us. So, and you've probably come from different parts of Myanmar to be here with us. So I want to thank all of you. And please do ask your questions if you have any on the forum. We'll be delighted to answer.
Okay. So that was the recording. So that's the end of the presentation. I wanted to give a feel for how we did this workshop. So, the way we did this workshop was we did a coordinator workshop. One person came from each center, and then we made this available in all the centers and they received it live. All the interactions, just like you were doing, and then individual learning is through spoken tutorial, and they had to ask questions in the forum. And then we interacted with all the people at three times in the day, once in the morning, once at just before lunch, and once in the evening. And it was all a one-day workshop. Now we are doing it over 3 days because this kind of interactive workshop webinar mode has become a lot more acceptable now. And so we have no difficulty in doing it now. So that is a summary of how we conducted workshops. Are there any questions? I want to point out one important takeaway from this workshop. Some of you might even say that, why are they using spoken tutorials? Why not live lectures? For those of you who had installed eSIM through a live session yesterday, would understand what it is. Because if I'm not mistaken, Saurabh started helping you with the installation at 11:30. and then catering to each person, their questions, answering them, and so on and so forth. He said he was busy till 1:30. Later on, I asked him in the evening, how did the workshop go? He said everything was okay, except that installation session, it was chaotic. It was chaotic because, you know, first of all, it took a long time. And second of all, there were people who were waiting for their problems to be answered. If he answered somebody at 1:30, then that person waited from 11:30 to 1:30. Okay. And mind you, there were not too many people who had this problem. Most people had installed. So if all people are going to be available, all people are going to be asking questions, and you have to answer them, it would have taken a lot of time. Even if there are only 10 people, even if there are only 10 people who have doubts, and you have to address them one by one, it would have taken a lot of time. The kind of things that we are doing here, we are able to achieve through spoken tutorials, could not have been done through a live session. Okay. So some of you might say that, you know, why are they doing eSIM? Why are they doing spoken tutorial? We have chosen that because that is the best way. That is the best way because it permits people to learn at their own speed. Somebody may say, oh, this is very well known to me. I'll skip this tutorial. I'll go to the next tutorial. Perfect. Somebody might say that I want to watch it 1.5x. Somebody might say, well, actually, I know most of it, but some parts of it I don't know. Let me listen to that part 3 times because that's a difficult portion. All other I will watch at 1.5x, 1.2x, but this particular part I will watch 3 times because I want to understand it well. So there are many benefits in learning one-on-one. And this kind of method will work even with 1,000 people. 1,000 people joining, each one has their own spoken tutorial. Each one listens to the spoken tutorial that comes on the screen in front of them, right? So it doesn't matter the teacher is far away. Where the teacher is, it doesn't matter. Whether the teacher is in this country or elsewhere, it doesn't matter at all. Okay. Yeah, spoken tutorials are available here. You can take them, use them. And moreover, because we are not delivering any lectures, spoken tutorials are delivering lectures. You can also use them. In other words, you can conduct workshops using spoken tutorials yourselves. You don't need us. Of course, if you do conduct a workshop and you want us to help you with answering forum questions, we'll be happy to contribute. From wherever we are, we'll be able to, all we have to do is just to check if there are any questions. If there are questions, we just go and answer. It won't take much time. So there are many different reasons why we have chosen this method. And that is why I showed that paper, training 10,000 teachers through weapons of mass instruction. Okay. So this is all I wanted to do. Wanted to talk. Are there any questions on the way we conducted this workshop? We have, of course, specialized it now. When the pandemic came, we were already well prepared because we had done several such workshops. We immediately rolled out the whatever we are doing now. Okay. Okay, I'm done. Usha, is there anything else I should talk about? Saurabh?
No, sir. I think you have covered it, everything nicely.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Yeah, bye.
Bye.
There's a question in the chat, actually. It is regarding the spoken tutorial. Will they be available after the workshop? So, sir, would you like to?
Yeah, so spoken tutorials are available in the website here. So let me just show you that. So this is in spoken tutorial website. If you just go to spoken tutorial, this is our website, and then go to eSIM. We haven't dubbed in other languages. English is there. So all these tutorials are there. You can go and listen to it anytime. And you can see that it says login because I have not logged in. Because I have not logged in, it says us, it wants me to log in. So here we are. Okay. So the answer is yes. It's always available. You can go and use them. And the forum questions are also available. And I'm also happy to know that you asked questions. And then one of the things that you may want to do is, by the way, there is also another one called, if you look at here, there is a tab called most active questions. If you click this, then latest questions will be there. Okay. So today, no question, recent post, 12th February, 12th is today. So Mathusri has posted, let's see what Python window not opening. Yeah. So for example, this is yesterday, Sonia Behra asked this question. Python window is not there. And then Sumanto has given the reply. And then this is somebody else. Abitri Bharti has written. And then Mathusri says, keep step time 10 milliseconds and proceed. Is Mathusri one of the participants of the workshop?
Sir, myself, Sri Ranjani, sir. My mail ID, user ID, I have given Mathusri, that's sir.
Okay. So anybody who, whoever enters here, they get, you know, they can answer. People, in fact, Sri Ranjani, when did you do this? When did you learn eSIM?
No, sir. Morning, I had the same problem, sir. Okay. So Saurabh cleared that. One. So,
you cleared, so you are able to answer, you are able to help somebody else, right?
Yes, sir.
That is the power of this.
Yes, the power very, of this. Simple, very simple, very simple. Very interesting. Very interesting. Mind using MATLAB and Simulink. Mm-hmm. Okay, now I feel very comfortable using this software, sir. Yeah. Very nice. For my students, I will definitely.
You should use it. What I'm saying is, you should also use the forum, like the way you helped other people.
Yes, sir. Right? Sure.
So what I suggest is you may all want to keep your eye on this. Keep your eye on this previous page just here and then most active questions. And then any question comes, just go and answer. Okay. So that's all I thought I will do.
Hello.
Sri Ranjini, from what college are you?
I'm from Sastra University, sir.
From Sastra.
Tamil Nadu.
Tanjavur, Tamil Nadu. Yes.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Very good. Happy that you could join us.
Yes. Thank you.
Hello, sir.
Yeah. Go ahead, Gopal.
Sir, what is the use of Python plot?
What is the use of?
Python plot.
Python plot?
Huh.
We're just using a plot, using Python created plots. That's all.
So, you can, sir, if I may interrupt.
Yeah.
Yeah, so Mr. Gopal, you can actually save those Python plots into an image. If you see the Python plot when it appears, there is an option that you can scale. There is an option through which you can actually save the image. There is a save floppy disk icon on the top of the Python plot. So you can actually save that plot as an image. So that's why it is there.
Okay. So if there are no more questions, is there a fast forward option in the spoken tutorial? We can use the, you have to use the slider, that's all. You have to use the slider and that's about it. Because we are saying that we don't want to tie you up with one browser or one player. You can use any player that you are comfortable with and use it. Okay. So I'm going to stop here. Thanks for listening to me and asking questions. And I want all of you to take this workshop seriously. It's extremely useful. As I mentioned to you, this is something that you can use in industry also legally. Tomorrow, some of you may want to, some faculty members may want to do some consulting for companies. And unfortunately, you may not be able to use academic license for consulting jobs, okay? Same thing for small companies. They may not have the money to spend a lot of money in buying PSPICE, Cadence, Suite, T-Spice, and so on. Whereas this is available free of cost. It's legal. And not only that, you can also keep improving it. Like yesterday, you were shown the cloud version of it. I assume that you liked it, right? So because we are developing it, we can improve it. We can go on improving it. In fact, we had Sumoto joined as a fellow. Then he's helping us now. We also have Ashutosh, who joined as a fellow. And then he joined as a semester-long intern. By the way, that internship is open now. In case anybody is interested, you can inform Saurabh. We might have closed it, but we may, in special cases, we may make an exception. If you can convince Saurabh, we may be able to take that person. So there are people who come and work with us, help improve, and all the improvements go back to the community, go back to you. It's a free software. You can take it and use it. So that is the reason why we should promote it. And of course, it is free. Whereas if you want to use a commercial software, it is going to be a lot more expensive. And if anybody uses commercial software without paying license fee, they will get into a lot of trouble. Because nowadays, all things are systems are connected. Everybody will come to know. And this software will keep saying, I'm here, I'm here, I'm here. So then there is a problem. So that is the reason. Okay, so I'll stop here. Thank you very much. Enjoy the rest of the workshop. I'll come back from time to time. Yeah.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, bye.
Bye, sir. So the next spoken tutorial which we need to follow is the spoken tutorial session on laying tracks on PCB. So you can start practicing this tutorial. And in case of any doubts, you can actually post it on the spoken tutorial forum and we will start answering them. And I have once again put the attendance form on the chat window. So if anyone has missed it, please fill it before 1 p.m. so that we don't need to open it again in the afternoon. So till 1 p.m. it is open. Please fill the attendance.